No test, no entry. That's the message from the National Party to returning Kiwis who'd need a negative COVID-19 test to re-enter the country. Judith Collins released the party's border security policy today, which includes a warning to border staff to use contact tracing methods or risk losing their job. Political reporter Mikey Sherman has more.
The Prime Minister donning a gown and mask, visiting lab workers processing thousands of COVID tests a day.
We did the very first genome back in February.
National says this community outbreak is down to the government's soft approach.
This is tough, but tough times need tough measures.
Crusher Collins promising just that.
New Zealand borders will be tough.
National's policy would mean Kiwis overseas must test negative for COVID-19 before coming home.
It's a very small price for someone to pay to help keep the country safe.
It'll still mean 2 weeks managed isolation.
It does set an expectation that there are regulations we have in New Zealand that you will need to comply with before you hop on the plane.
People can be in transit for quite some period of time. So there's no evidence that that would necessarily reduce the number of positive cases.
As for those who simply cannot get a test,
they can't come back.
It's going to create a human rights issue in the sense that citizens and residents have a right to come home.
We also look at the human rights of the New Zealanders who are here.
A new border protection agency would streamline the government response.
So that we don't end up with this mad scramble of different ministers and different agencies.
I'm not sure at this point that another bureaucracy is necessarily going to help here.
Another promise, shorter wait times for a test.
We've said 60 minutes because that's a lunchtime.
Border staff would also be required to use contact tracing technology.
Something like the COVID card.
Failure to use it can expect that tough approach.
Then they wouldn't be working there.
They'd lose their job.
That's the one.
The ACT Party getting in on the tough love. Its new border policy includes self-isolation in Airbnb with the possibility of strict punishment.
If you break your isolation, then you spend the last 14 days in Mount Eden.
National says its policy means targeted and shorter lockdowns.
You might have part of a suburb, you might have a street, it may be a grouping of people.
Wouldn't a suburb lockdown be a logistical nightmare?
Everything is a logistical nightmare if you're not prepared.
Preparation the key, with the opposition putting forward its plans.
And so we've seen the opposition's plans there, but the government also today announced $6 million to help beef up security at managed isolation and quarantine facilities. That will include CCTV thermal cameras, which basically trips an alarm if returnees attempt to abscond from those facilities. It'll also include alarmed fencing, so some tough new measures there.
And Mikey, Cabinet meets tomorrow to evaluate our current alert levels. When are we expecting a decision on this?
That's right. Cabinet ministers will meet tomorrow morning to go over the latest information. That will include the latest case numbers. And then we will, of course, have that 1 p.m. press conference from both Ashley Bloomfield and Jacinda Ardern. They'll give us the latest thinking behind that latest information. But don't expect a decision on moving in and out of alert levels tomorrow. The government wants to take the weekend, the next few days, just to watch how those case numbers go. We have seen new cases pop up every day this week. What they do not want to see is new clusters. So expect that big, big call around those alert levels on Monday next week.
All right. Thanks for the update, Mikey. Mikey Sherman at Parliament.